Does the European Union have the power to help protesters in Iran in any meaningful way at all? And if so, how is it doing
that?
Not
only do we have the responsibility to act, but we have also the right to act and support the protesters in Iran. As being the only union of democracies in the world, I do believe that the European Union, where we showed solidarity with Ukraine, we can do the same with the protesters in Iran who are demanding basic human rights and freedoms.
What does the current political relationship between the European Union and the government of Iran look like? Where do we stand with trade deals, and where do we stand with the nuclear agreement? And will those be affected by the current protests?
When it comes to the relations between the EU and Iran, they are not so deep, but still, of course, we negotiate with them about the atom deal that we have. And it is part of a greater international framework, and not only there is no association agreement or any kind of a trade agreement with Iran because of the international sanctions imposed on the country.
There are many people across the European Union who wish to support the protesters in Iran in their fight for freedom. They do this by raising awareness already. However, meaningful impact on the ground is needed. What do you recommend to achieve this? How can we support so that people on the ground get actual?
Well, I do understand the will to help and support, and I do believe that there are many things that we can do, but the most important thing now is to keep the momentum and the pressure on the national governments in the member states so they put the Revolutionary Guard on the terrorist list. That is the basic and most thought for ask from the protesters in Iran. So keep up the pressure on your prime ministers, on the foreign affairs ministers in the EU, so they can come to a common conclusion and put the Revolutionary Guard on the terrorist list.